Okay. So let's get started with the day two. I hope you had a good day one yesterday. We talked about the basics of data visualization. We talked about different charts. We talked about what are the benefits of data visualization. What are the basic differences between the different career paths in the field of data science. So we talked about a lot of things. And yes, we also talked about exploratory data analysis, right, which is one of the most important topics in statistics and in data analysis. So going forward, we also talked about, I don't know why my voice is getting echoed. Okay, going forward, we'll also be talking about more about business intelligence module, and then we'll also talk about what is Tableau, and we'll quickly jump into Tableau. So the next 3 days, probably today, tomorrow, and day after tomorrow, we'll be talking more about Tableau functionalities. And of course, Friday will be our lovely building a live dashboard, where we will be taking a live example, live data set, and we'll be building dashboard from scratch in front of you. Okay, that's the entire agenda, and Saturday we'll be discussing the assignments for you, where you will be, you know, going through the assignments, taking 24 hours time, and submitting us the assignment results by the end of Monday. So today's agenda is very clear. Let me introduce you to the trainer of today's class. Sorry for not having on my video. Today's class is going to be taught by Mr. Olio. So he is a lead data science instructor at Xccelerate, and he is a master's in statistics from UC Berkeley. He has more than 12 years, 14 years, right, Olio? 10 plus years of experience, and he's quite experienced in data analysis, data science, and especially he's our Tableau expert. So what are you, Olio? You can start.
Okay, thank you, Seth. Let me introduce myself. My name is Olio, and I've been working 10 years in data analytics. So meanwhile, we will talk about a little bit about what we'll talk about today. We'll be talking about what is the BI. So it stands for business intelligence. It's the new term of data visualization, such as analysis. And then we will jump into the Tableau, which is one of the very popular BI tools in data analysis. Let's start our class. Are you excited? Okay, so let's start. I believe just now, yesterday, that Stan has gone over the data visualization part. So I briefly slow down, and then you have talked, we have a review of...
Sorry,
share your screen. Okay, yeah, too excited. So I share my screen now. So this is the slide you have. And then I believe that has over a bit of the data visualization, such as EDA. And here is Seth has covered the what is visualization, and then visualization can be some and then the EDA as well as the what is EDA, and then how do you perform in your business. So and then type of data that metrics. So I think it's already covered to up to the 28. So it's covered yesterday. So now is time to cover in the I am done. And then yes, now to talk about the BI process. So in the BI process, so like in the machine learning process, you will be having some EDA stuff, and then as well as doing model. And then BI is a specific one, will be when you get a data, and then you will do some analyze for the business. So in general, there's a few steps of the BI process, such as getting data, analyze visualization, publish, and then collaboration. So don't worry, I will talk a little bit one by one. So to get data, so in general, that's for a big company, they already store a lot of data into the data warehouse. So what is data warehouse is the warehouse that store up the, you get a lot of data from different sources, and then put the final data, which can be analyzed together in the data warehouse. So for the BI process, because we are want to having a dashboard, right? So I will show you what is the dashboard. Is that the interface, so you can use the data visualization to display to the user, which is some of in the business, you can say some CEO, your colleague, or other marketing officer, for example. So in generally, you can get the data. So data could be any type. There's many kind of data. So especially now in a big data era, and then so the simplicity, you can think of Excel file, Excel file, XLS, not XLS format. Okay, so Excel file, and then the basic format of Excel file is CSV. That could be sometimes people store the data into the server. So in general, we call it a SQL server, and then as well as other type of the data you can connect, and then that's the data. So whenever you have data, you can do the BI process. Otherwise, you are not. So for BI process, you have to use the the data to perform analysis. So we go through the data. The data is very important because we are data science, right? So we're getting a data. And then the next step will be some analysis. So in the analysis, you will be building the powerful model and then the classical measure. So sometimes like you have a data, if you as the things that whenever you have the data, if you do not do any analysis, it's just a data, it's just a number, right? So you the data, after you analyze, you can get the information. And the information is what we want to know. So many business has their business problem. So we will go through doing from the data and perform the analysis that you got the information. Okay. So once you get the information, then you can make a lot of decisions, right? And then jump to the next step, visualization. So why do we visualize? So sometimes some data is boring. That after you analyze, you can be very simple with Tableau result. And then this is good data analysis result also. But the thing is, you should be very understand the data so that you can get the insight immediately. But why do visualization is important? Because so throughout your visualization, you have the graph. So for example, you can let me draw something. So for example, your histogram. Then I don't know. so then you will know about the distribution of the data. So getting more clearly that you can understand for as well as is the most important is transfer the insight to the other user. And then let me clear this. So and the rest of them will be published and collaborate. So you get the data, you do the analysis, you get the business information, and then provide the visualization to the others. So now it is just you can see the report, right? So you have to share with others that what your findings. So publish is also a step. So you can share the so this is the thing is when you go to the Tableau, it has you can build a lot of visualization, and then after that we can build a report. So you get, when you build the reports, you can publish it, like doing a dashboard. So the dashboard is meaning putting all the different analysis together, so it become a story. So it is a example of the science process that the most important thing is to telling the user about the story of the data. So publishing is also important, and then you can also collaborate. So you can empower your organization with self-service analysis. So this is actually the same thing. It's sharing, and then sometimes if you will share with your analysis colleague, and then you will understand, and then you can discuss, and then we can do more beautiful BI. So this is the BI process. So do you have any questions? I believe no, right? So let's start to explore more. So Tableau and is architecture. So we come to the main dish of the for our 7 days. So yeah, let's talk about the Tableau. So Tableau is what is the Tableau? Tableau is a powerful and fast growing data visualization tool used in BI industry. So as I tell, it's a tool that's really popular. So in general, there's many BI tools. So let me list out something. So there's many BI tools. So Tableau, right? And then you can see in Microsoft has the Power BI. And then we'll be have a quick view or quick sense. So those are popular BI. And then there's many as well. So I list out these three because it's the most popular that many companies is using that to perform data analytics. So let's talk back about the Tableau. So Tableau help the world largest organization to unleash the power of their global access of their data and the people. So allow the customer to spend more time on data analysis and less on the data cleaning. So why is Tableau is and for the BI is so important is that. So when you do a DDA, so you when plot your graph, some explanation. Okay. So in general, you have x y axis, is x y axis. So you have a line chart, maybe line chart. So you have a line chart. But what is the meaning of this line chart? So we don't have any idea, right? But you have to put in the title, and then also the x axis, and then the y axis, So you will be more understanding things. So suppose this is the maybe you can here you can put the year and then just the count. Okay, so this is the timeline for the in the title you have the timeline of the count of the how many cells. So you have the cells so like something like that. The chart is something like that. So so you have to be specific to name the many settings. But in generally in the Tableau they have all the for example, this is one of the examples to explain in the line chart that would in general in data visualization we can have many charts, right? So in many charts you can choose it by different by the button in the Tableau, so you can interchange about the graph as well as the matrix. So it also allow you to do some what is that called? Is the formatting. So there's a lot of function that you don't have to in the for example you do build in the by the Python library and then you will have to put a lot of code on that. But Tableau is not it's almost a codeless without any code you can build a very beautiful Tableau. So it's allow the customer to spend more time on data analysis and less time on the data winding. It's help in simplify raw data in a very understand format. Also, giving the data set into the modeling will be for data analysis, you will have this has to be clean. So the data you have to spend a lot of time to do the cleaning, but here you can you can simplify the raw data. So if you Tableau will do some automatic job for you. So what's next? Tableau can help to create the data that can be understood by the profession and editor in the organization. It allows non-technical user to create a dashboard. So create a dashboard. So in general, you create the graph. It could be so can have some difficulty. But in general, here you understand the Tableau, and then you can easily to manage by that by using a drag and drop. So many people can create a dashboard. So the good thing is about the dashboard is that once you create a job, for example, if the Tableau is connected to the server, so the server when the server update, and then you just refresh your Tableau, and then so the Tableau will update the data. So for example, in a company, for example the data the sales performance of a month. So generally, I thought it would be finished and this part, and then help you. So once you in the you're talking about the sales monthly sales, and then we will update automatically by that will next month will be automatically update. Okay, so thank you, Danny, for handling that. So among that, we will talking the feature of the Tableau. It is the most significant feature as follows. You have an easy implementation, quality customer support, actually it's really good. So I talked a little bit about my experience then is that in the past I talked about my company started to use Tableau and then they give me a lot of support of the how do you use the Tableau, they give me a lot of information. And as well as the forum is really good. If someone is handling some of the query, so you can get if the sensitive data is sensitive, you can give them dummy data, and then they will try to support you with the and answer you with a question. And it is really good support. Amazing data visualization, of course. So that's why it's, many people are using that. Set data source integration, like sometimes you will have data integrated with that. Integrate with we have the data in separately. You don't want to call that together. They have the function of that. Mobile support, use a rich online community. Those things is I don't know. It's a good service you require in this area. So why do we use a Tableau? So we give a accessibility. So you can connect any data using a Tableau. It has an automated connector for database. So you'll see a little bit in the next slide is about how many type of data you can connect to our Tableau. Native platform. It's highly and used industrial tool and has a web use. You can pay with track with visualize you have create. So the good thing is that after you create the dashboard, then sometimes you can user can interact with the graph also. So yes, and then interactive visual is a top class of visualization tools, and then it has many visual for your data. You can use a very full of visualization to interpret your data easily. So yes, there's many visualization tools you can use. So but the thing is this is the tools. So even though it's a many function, you have to understand well that what is the good things about the what is the right chart, and then what do you want to show? You have to know it. And then quick prediction time. So this is tools is a very good in predictive design. So we will talk about it this later in this course. So okay, and then next. So that's a simple comparison with Tableau with our BI. So the thing is, Tableau is more expensive. So it starts at 500 user per year, and then Power BI starts at 5.9 per user per month. So use case implementation, customization, and then integration, customer support, those things is similar. So the rating is Tableau is a little bit the best. So talk a little bit about the Tableau will be so throughout this course we will that we have a different version of Tableau and then as a famous one it will be Tableau Desktop. This is the standard version of the Tableau. But the thing is, we have to pay money for that. So we choose a free version to try out the things, try out the functions. So that so comparing the Tableau Perfect and Tableau Desktop. So it's free for Tableau Perfect. Why do we still use the Tableau Desktop? Okay, so in generally, when you use the Tableau Desktop, after you do all the visualization, you can save as TWX. This is a file. So you scan the file and store it in your local machine. And then Tableau Perfect, you cannot. So you can save while you can save to the Tableau Perfect server. So in the server, but it is public, right? So there's no privacy. So that's why company will need to buy the license for Tableau Desktop. And then because this the data is a sensitive data, right? So it cannot be disclosed on the public. So you cannot use the Tableau Perfect. But for us, we have some paper data set, and then if you don't mind to share about your analysis about the data, so feel free to use Tableau Perfect.
Yeah. So just giving a small idea about this Tableau concept. So basically, you go to any tool, any BI tool, there will be two different versions of the tool. One will be the free version, one will be the paid version. So let's say in Power BI, we do have multiple options like Power BI Free, Power BI Pro, Power BI Premium. So in any of these tools, in the free version, you will be able to practice it, but you will not be able to publish anything. Similarly, in Tableau, there are two different options. One is Tableau Public and one is Tableau Desktop. In the Tableau Desktop, probably you will not be having access to Tableau Desktop. Only if you have a student ID, you can probably try it out and download it, but I'm not sure if you will be able to download it or not. So when you join organizations, when you have license keys, then only you will be able to get access to Tableau. And Tableau licenses are way, way costlier as compared to Power BI. Tableau Public is the free version which is available to the entire public. And that is one of the reasons you can easily install Tableau Public and get started with your learning process. Yeah, over to you on your things.
Okay, so I add a little bit. So actually you can download Tableau Desktop also. But the thing is they only get you a 14-day trial. So sometimes when you do a project, you want to use the function of saving the file into your desktop. And then we will try, I ask them to, how about you try Tableau Desktop and then install that and then use that within the 14 days. So after the 14 days, you is not allowed to open it. So you generally will need to buy the product key for them. So that's about the comparison. So the next one will be the Tableau architecture. So just now I have described some of them that you can connect of different sources, such as you can see MySQL, Oracle SQL Server. That's a database, a data warehouse that we need to connect. As well as you can see some others, such as Facebook, S3-based, SaaS, and then many, for example, also Microsoft Office. Those kind of different kind of the data source, they can, this is available in Tableau to connect to the Tableau. So you can, so the simple thing will be, for example, simple one will be some Excel file or CSV file connect to the Tableau. And then there's also something that in the server, is a data warehouse you can connect to the Tableau also, and as well as some new kind of data source they can still provide. For example, like you can some file is called geo special. I forgot the name, but it's about the geographical coordinate. So you can import to the data. So if you're interested, you can explore about it more. And then after we get the source, we can do the ETL. So we extract that and load it into the Tableau. So in the Tableau, you can be do many things in there. So I don't specify talk much more about that, but the most important, so we will talk about the most important feature is the visualization. So we will talk about that. And then as well as some kind of other function, we will be seeing in the in the Tableau, but we will focus on this site. So after you do the visualization, we can demonstrate the dashboard. So for the dashboard, we can read through the many sources because this is just like a browser. So if you can be displayed on your laptop, desktop, could be some notepad about the iPad, for example, and also in your mobile also. So so in general, when you build, you have multiple sources. Different people can use multiple devices to access it. So this is a convenience. So this is the... So in general, we can install Tableau through this link. So for example, you can go to the search for Tableau topic download. So you can see try Tableau for free. And then here you can take the try Tableau for free. Then you register. After you register, then you can request the free trial and then you can use that. So a little bit talk about the borderline. So borderline will be some Tableau server, Tableau online, Tableau public, Tableau desktop, and then Tableau with Tableau mobile. And this is all about the things that you can access throughout the different device. So mainly we will cover here will be the Tableau public. Of course, it's because it's free. And then again, the advantage of that will be a high performance, low cost, mobile friendly, quality customer service, expensive customer resources, ease of case, and easy to upgrade. All those things I have covered that before. So the next session will be talking about how to use Tableau. So beforehand, do you have any question yet? I believe, all right. We check a little bit before. Oh, thank you, Rick. Oh, so okay, I a little bit summarize that. Yesterday we talked about the slide that you can review the slide that is from the page 1 to 28. It's talk about the data visualization, the concept of this data visualization, the EDA, and as well as the data type. So you can check this out for that. So let me go back to how to use Tableau. So this is the section on how to use Tableau. So we will visualize that into to say about how to use the Tableau. So that's the things. The first thing you need to use the Tableau, of course, as I said before, is that the data, right? So you do not have data, you cannot do anything for analysis, right? So the data is very important. So so whenever you open the Tableau, we will be the first thing is ask you to connect to the data. So in the Tableau dashboard or topic, you can have a connect thing. So under the search, we can search a Tableau server, and then you can search the Tableau server, and then you can use Tableau online also. But the thing is you have to sign in, you have to have a license. So for the Tableau online, you can enter your email address as well. So you have to register. So in general, in Tableau public, let me open Tableau public. So I start to search about Tableau public. So my version is last year. I think they have the. It is very important. And as well as the. So the next session will be talking about how to use Tableau. So beforehand, do you have any question yet? Oh, so okay, I a little bit summarize that. Yesterday we talked about the slide that you can review the slide that is from the page 1 to 28. It's talk about the data visualization, the concept of this data visualization, the EDA, and as well as the data type. So you can check this out for that. So let me go back to how to use Tableau. So this is the section on how to use Tableau. So we will visualize that into to say about how to use the Tableau. So that's the things. The first thing you need to to use the Tableau, of course, as I said before, is that the data, right? So you do not have data, you cannot do anything for analysis, right? So the data is very important. So whenever you open the Tableau, we will be the first thing is ask you to connect to the data. So in the Tableau dashboard or topic, you can have a connecting. So under the search, you can search a Tableau server, and then you can search the Tableau server, and then you can use Tableau online also. But the thing is, you have to sign in, you have to have a license. So for the Tableau online, you can enter your email address as well. So you have to register. So in general, in Tableau public, let me open Tableau public. So I start to search about Tableau public. So my version is last year. I think they have the more update one. So let's load it.
So somebody has a problem with the downloading app. Maybe if you haven't downloaded it, then probably you can watch out today's class. Let's just watch it out. And after the class is over, you can download. In case you have any questions, you can reach out to us on mail. I know that some of you are not getting emails because of some glitch. So in case anybody who hasn't received yesterday's details, probably try to send a mail to this email ID I will just ping in the chat box. So just immediately reach out to us if you aren't getting the emails, and we'll quickly sort it out. Okay. So yeah, if you haven't installed Tableau, it is completely okay. Let's just watch this video and watch today's class, and then after today's class, you can check out, install it in your laptop for the day three.
So meanwhile, when it's opening, I add a little bit. So today, what we do today will be some interface of the Tableau. So we're not going to deep in the analysis part. So in generally, so you can watch out this video, and then I believe that after you register, it will have the they will automatically download the Tableau public. And then pull out the they will give you a .exe file, and then this is a very easy process to install the Tableau. So don't worry about that. So if you have any question, you can reach out to us. So let me I think it's already open. Let me yes. So I put this screen on the side. So let me swap my screen. So that's the template of the first page of the Tableau. So first we will talk about the right hand side. It has the screen, right, that discover. It is the has many because we talk about Tableau, it has a lot of good support, right? So they have a really good documentation as well. Here you can have many ways, the links, this thing will be as well as the description. So when you click that, you can go to the page that can help you to understand more about the Tableau. So as well as some sample data sets, live string link, boss. So those things will help you a lot when you in the data set you have many idea of analysis. We will can help you right away. And then here we ask you to update the this version. We do it later on. So the latest one is 2021 April 4. So I think it's not too old, is it? So I think it's okay. So another thing is the middle one. So you can see there's a servo tab, right? So this means that I have create many the Tableau that save on the Tableau public. So I have published that on the Tableau the server. So it will display in like that. But for the first time, don't worry about that. It's will be empty because you haven't create any Tableau analysis. So the left one will be the one you will so see this the slide is that the connections. So this thing is that you to connect the files like Microsoft Excel, text file, JSON file, Microsoft Access, PDF, spectacle file, and statistic file. So this one is about the simple, maybe you have download some files, and then you can import it locally. So whenever the files like in your desktop or in a notebook, then you can import it, and then start to do analysis. And then the other part will be the server. So you can see more here is that can connect Google Drive, some old data, web data also, Google Suite and Google Drive as well. So those are the things that so in general you can connect to server, but you have to do some of the setup so that you can connect to the Tableau, those server data in the Tableau. But simply we more focus on the Excel file and for example CSV file that as an elementary data source for us to do analysis. go back to screen. Little bit I accept I will explain a little bit the concept about the Tableau data type first, and then we will use semantically explain that into Tableau, and then we'll describe the data type as well. So that's same type they have in the integer real number and other type. So we will check that in the Tableau. So you say your Tableau desktop, so we use the Tableau public instead. And then that's the UI. So in general, let's explain a little bit here, and then we will see it into the Tableau public. So you have whenever you connect to the data, we will jump. We will have the first page of the data connection, and once we have the connection, you have the status bar here, and then also the sum of the street type, some cars, toolbars, wheels, workspace control, workbook name, and then web data window. So we will explain that in a moment, so that we will understand more. So I think okay. So after we talk about this, we can, and then after that we will have been demo. So those are the most important concept. So in the Tableau, you have the dimension measures. So this is the main important concept of the Tableau. So dimension can typically contain the qualitative values such as name, date, geographical data, and measure typically contain the things you can measure like numerical and quantitative values. So we will explain it in a minute. So dimension is that it's in an independent variable, and measure is a field that is a dependent variable. But there's a more conceptual difference. So we will explain a little bit more when we go to the demo session. And then there's also in the right side, you have the show me section. It's still released out all the graph. So you can interchange the graph. For example, you have in a table, some data in a table format, you can change to the bar chart as well. So how about we takes a break. So we come back. Wait, how many minutes went for the break?
5 minutes.
Workspace control, workbook name, and then work data window. So we will explain that in a moment, so that we will understand more. So I think okay. So after we talk about this, we can, and then after that we will have been demo. So those are the most important concepts. So in the Tableau, you have the dimension measures. So this is the main important concept of the Tableau. So dimension can typically contain the qualitative values such as name, date, geographical data, and measure typical contain the things you can measure like numerical and qualitative values. So we will explain it in a minute. So dimension is that it's in an independent variable, and measure is a field that is a dependent variable. But there's a more conceptual difference. So we will explain a little bit more when we go to the demo session. And then there's also in the right side, you have the show me section. It's still released out all the graph. So you can interchange the graph. For example, you have in a table, some data in a table format, you can change to the bar chart as well. So how about we take a break? So we come back. How many minutes for the break?
5 minutes.
5 minutes? Oh, okay, so I take 5 minutes. Okay. So come back. You can change to a bar chart as well. The things you can measure like numerical and quantitative values. So So we will explain it in a minute. So dimension is that is in a independent variable and measure. So how about we take a break? So we come back. How many minutes left for the break? Just now we have seen this kind of things in a PowerPoint. So let's go to the view table and explore about the interface. So suppose we want to here we just now we have opened the Tableau topic, right? So we get back to into this page. The thing is as we described just now, we have to connect the data in order to do analysis. So throughout that we will have data. This is called Global Super Store. So as I described before, that we can connect Microsoft Excel or text file. So this file is Excel file. So you use the Microsoft Excel connector to import the data. So you can click the Microsoft Excel. Maybe we'll load the browser, and then we will let me open the 7-day Tableau, and then we want this file to be loaded. So meanwhile, we will be need some time for the Tableau to know about the dataset. So you say persisting the request. So and then we will have this page. So it is automatically the data source will using the same name as your Excel file. So for example, this one will be used in the here. You can change your name also. This is your data source. So let me open this one in the Excel format to see what's going on. Analysis. So throughout that, we will have data. This is called Global Super Store. So as I described before, that we can connect Microsoft Excel or text file. So this file is Excel file. So you use the Microsoft Excel connector to import the data. So you can click the Microsoft Excel. Maybe we'll load the browser, and then we will let me open the 7-day Tableau, and then we want this file to be loaded. So meanwhile, we will be need some time for the Tableau to load about the dataset. So you say persisting the request. So and then we will have this page. So it is automatically the data source will using the same name as your Excel file. So for example, this one will be used in the here. You can change your name also. This is your data source. So let me open this one in the Excel format to see what's going on, and then see the Tableau public what's going on. So we open it in the Excel file. So this is Excel data, and then we have orders, returns, and people's tab. So order is about the information about the orders. For example, you have order days, shipping information, customer information, as well as the days and market, and also with the sales and sales information as well. So this I think this is the main source of the orders. And then you have the tab of returned page, and then also a person. It is a more description of, I think, is in the orders. But for simplicity, we will just use this tab for so now we will more introduce with the one table of data in the Tableau. So I close it first. So in the Tableau, after you load the Excel file, you can find there's three tabs here, right? So it is the three tabs from the Excel file. So for simplicity, we just use the order. So we put order in here. So after we check the orders to them, we start to expand it one by one. So the left hand side, this one will be your data source. So it is a more description of, I think it's file. Go the browser, and then we will let me open the data table, and then we want this file to be loaded. So meanwhile, we will need some time to, for the table to know about the dataset. So you say processing the request. So and then we will have this page. So it is automatically the data source will using the same name as your Excel file. So for example, this one will be used in here. You can change your name also. This is your data source. So let me open this one in the Excel format to see what's going on, and then see the Tableau public what's going on. So we open it in the Excel file. So it's the Excel data, and then we have orders, returns, and people's tab. So order is about the information about the orders. For example, you have order days, shipping information, customer information, as well as the days and market, and also with the sales and sales information as well. So this, I think this is the main source of the orders. And then you have the tab of returned page, and then also a person. It is a more description of, I think, is in the orders. But for simplicity, we will just use this tab for so now we will more introduced with the one table of data in the Tableau. So I close it first. So in the Tableau, after you load the Excel file, you can find there's a three tabs here, right? So it is the three tabs from the Excel file. So for simplicity, we just use the order. So we put order here. So after we check the orders to there, we start to explain it one by one. So the left hand side, this one will be your data source. So and then this is your connection, so that it gives out the speed tab of the Excel, and then we use choosing order. So here we'll change a little bit, right? So it's order and under the Excel file. So it is describing the order. This is all the data from the order page. So and then here will be if we later on we talk with next two lessons, we'll be talking about the multiple source. We will explain that in this one. Okay, so and then also talk about the interface in here, right? So in this interface that we will show out the sample data. So it is showing not all the data. So it's just simply show out the sample data of the of your order in your order table. So as you see, it is the same as just now we saw in the Excel. You have the order ID, order day or shipping day, customer information, as well as city stage, and then the shipping and order information. So all the information is about these things, the orders. Okay, so let me talk this a little bit more. Is that each it is whenever you load the data into Tableau, they will help you to display in this format. So they will based on your data type, and then to detect your data type. So for example, a pun is meaning the numerical data, and ABC is a text data, and this one is the date data, as well as later on you can see some this one like a world is about the geographical data. What else? I think that's it. So you can click about this one, and then you can see it is numerical data, which is a whole number. You can choose numerical decimal, daytime, days, string, or boolean. So you can interchange with the data type or as well. As well as you can see that there's a row shape of the data type. It's about the zip code of the postcode. It's more about the geographical role. So in generally, you will see that it's a city, it's a geographical role, and then you can see it's a city, and then here it's defaulted as a country or region. So this is about the data type, and then you can do the change of data type also. Because like for example, row ID, right? So it's all the number. But in generally, we are not doing a lot of analysis use the row ID, right? So it's just an index. So the thing is, you can change this one into a string also. So you will load the data and then start to trim the data type. As well as sometimes the date, right? So because date format is pretty tricky, you still have American style, you have a US style, you can have a long form or short form of the month, you can change. You can sometimes the computer may not be able to tap it into handle it. So so we have successfully changed the format of the type, right? So and then so in, when the data is ready, so I think now it's ready, and then we can go to the web sheet. So you can go to the suite one. So this is another things about the about the interface. After you put the orders, and then so it is processing of the data, and then we can start to use that to be analyze things. There's many things you can do here. Is that so just now you can see in the Excel that you have many different data column in here. So so here it will display the column name as well as the data type also, right? So for example, just now we have changed the ID, I think the row ID. So row ID is become here, right? So it is a string. Okay. So in this tab, it's showing all the columns. So as well as the you can search about that. So by C, you can see a city, and then you can find the city in these things. As sometimes when you have a lot of columns, it's better have a search function. So it's pretty good. And so those things, and then after that, we'll be having this kind of cut. So the cuts include many things. We have columns or rows. So we'll see in a minute when we have a demonstration of the showing the code, using the code rows and column to pull apart. And then mask is also important that you will be use that for the analysis as well. So inside that will be the content. So in the content will be the visualization you want to see. For example, we'll see a table or graph in here. And then as well as the filtering will pop up more the next section. So that's also show me here. You can see, excuse me. So you can see the graph. There's many type of graph in there. We have a table, bar chart, mapping, pie chart, tree map, line chart, area chart, something like that. So, but the color is dim, right? So you cannot able to use that. Why? Because you have to have the correct position of putting the data, and then they will have so they will become more colorful, and then you can select those, and then they will, you can interchange with that with the graph also. So I think the first step is to use the simple example to make it more. So for example, we have a buffer. We put in anything. So it will be loading that the sum of the buffer is the 1467557. So it's 14,000K of the sum of the buffer. So the thing is that's very special things here. So as I mentioned in the slide that in here is that you have the UI has the dimension and measure things. So the dimension is about the quantitative value, right? And then the dimension is the field of about the independent variable, and then measure is things to contain things you can measure by numerical. So profit is for example will be for numerical. So they will automatically generate aggregation for the this one. So for taking a look at breakdown, maybe we will need to put in some category. For example, we put a category in here. So the category has V types, like furniture, office supplies, and technology expanded. So the graph become more visible than technology. So these three things will be separated by the by each category, and then each category will be having the sum of the profit. So in default, it is now displayed in the bar chart, right? So so now it becomes many things to many graph that you can use, you can choose also. So suppose the most simple one, the traditional one, will be a Tableau format. So you can see the exact number of the furniture is 28,500. I said office supplies is 5,800, and technology is 63,000. So in here you can there's a many function in here. You can will be displayed when you hold over the test. So in here we supposedly we want to find the highest problem one in here. So by sorting you can sort the value. So so that the highest problem will be shown in here. So as well as you can change the to the bar chart or pie chart, okay? So we want to choose the bar chart. So this is the horizontal one is showing the bar chart. So a little bit talk about the max, right? So max is many combination with other tasks. We can do some visualization change. So supposedly here you can have seen the each character and then see how many program by all over the mouse, and then you can see all the program is 2, 5, 0, 8, 3, okay. So this is the program. But the thing is some I don't want suppose we don't want to use with the mouse that we want to show in the PowerPoint. So you cannot know now only the approximate number of the open. So the thing is you can put a profile again. So we want to know have a label of that. We'll check this one to the label. So that in the bar chart you will show out the sum of profile is 285,000 in the furniture. And then you can here you can sort the this thing again. So you can also interchange with the pie chart again. So let me explain a little bit about the another concept. So in this switch, so we are talking about the we can rename the street name. So this street you can call cat one. So category change a little bit by double clicking and change bar. Okay, so you are using a bar chart to visualize the this page. So let me duplicate this one. In here, you can right click and then you can duplicate your sheet. So supposedly it will be giving the same visualization. But the thing is this one I want a pie chart. So for here you can take a look of the show me and then find that you have a pie chart, right? So put in the pie chart. So it will show out the pie chart in there. So you hide as behind the show me, and then you can find that that's also the legend of the each character. But the thing is we also want to for example we want to show out the some of the profit in test. Here we can put in the label. So so we have the information about the category and as well as the over. So we have create one bar chart and one pie chart. So for example we want to have making a report of that. Okay. So when you create a report that you can see you have a data source that you will show later that is coming back to the main page as sometimes you want to do some setting on the data set on itself. And then this the suite we just create, right? So anytime we can create a suite of the new suite and then do some analysis. So and then if you don't want that, we can rename that. You can even write it that we can delete that. And then duplicate we have shown you before. So after you duplicate and then you can having a true chart. So here's the another function of the Tableau. It's a different things about different that of the worksheet. We have a dashboard and a story. So this is another mode of to show out to two or more visualization. So you can click the new dashboard. Okay, so this is another screen, right? So it's a lot like the screen one. So in that it has a lot of it is about the more about the setting of the layout of the dashboard. You can have a default mode or the you can switch to the phone mode. And then size you can change a little bit. For example, I don't want the screen to be too small. And then here you can choose automatically. So the dashboard become full screen. And then this is your dashboard then. And then there's a bit different function about the dashboard that so that you can build into the dashboard, which help the help you to formalize the dashboard. So how do we usually use the dashboard? It's simple. You can we have create a category bar chart and the category pie chart, right? So we need to those two and then drag and drop into the thing. So we can see that it's already showing the category. It's about the pie chart of the bar chart of the category of the summary of the profile, and then you can put the pie chart as well. So so sometimes you can interchange. For example, this one. We don't want to put in here because sometimes it is the official design is it is like that. All the legend will be on the side, but sometimes if you don't want that, you can change it to the there's a lot of setting you can throw it, and then this one we can move. For example, we can put aside the pie chart. Then because the pie chart is like that, and you can fit the entire wheel. So let me move this. So this the formatting is used up to you to customize. So for the dashboard, this one may not be looking so good, and then you can edit the title to be so you change a little bit about the things is often what is that, the category. So about this is a bar chart. Okay, and then you change. And as well as here, you can rename that profile. I can. So we have both bar chart and pie chart here. So we have the dashboard showing all the material with the simple analysis. So let me talk one more for the report. So this is good enough for the report. And then actually you can add more visualization among them. So but in general I don't recommend you input a lot. It's what is become a computing. So I think here for graph is successfully built a small story. So another things we talk about will be story mode. So here you we create a new dashboard. Now we can create a new story. So in the story mode, it's another things to the reporting. So this is talking about maybe your findings. So for example, you want to put a bar chart there. So for example, you can give a caption for that. So it is a open by category. So you have import the first chart, and then for story mode, you can add the story point. So for example, you can expand story mode. For example, here you want to use the pie chart. For example, you can this is open by category by pie chart. So this one is you cannot go back to edit it with the bar. So we have story mode, and then for example, sometimes you can give one more this, and then we drag and drop the dashboard here. So the dashboard it can be included in the story mode. So for example, you may say this is so in general, of course, you will not like your story. You can have many typing some business insight in there instead of I'm just showing the demonstration about the script how can be used the story mode. So for example, we can actually you can also duplicate the slide. So we'll give you the duplicate slide. And then if you want to cancel, just cancel. So let me do one more is that introduction. So introduction this type you can actually this type can be moved around. So sometimes you have a lot of analysis, but when you experiment a story, you have to move the graph around that. So here you can use the you can use the function object to act as it is an intro to the open by category. So you can move around in that. Actually, you can edit the description, and then if you don't like the color, you can change it into other color. So that we can format that, and then edit this one to be bigger. that's an example of using the different modes. So that's what we cover for today. So let's wrap up. So today I talked about the different things from trading language. So we talked about the BI process from the getting data and analysis, and then the also the visualization. So this is main core process of the BI. And then you will use the public and collaborate with others or other users. And then we have talked about what is Tableau and architecture. We have talked a lot of the good things about the Tableau and then why we use Tableau, because it's especially good for data analysis and EDA, exploring data analysis. And then we have talked about a little bit about the Tableau, we have the Power BI, then the architecture. And then we will, after class, I hope you can install the Tableau with the Tableau public. I think it's easy, really easy to install. You can, after install, you can try out different interface. And then we talk about the borderline and the advantage and how to use Tableau. So we explain what is the how to connect to data. So you need data to connect to the Tableau. So it can be many different kind of source. So for simple one, we will talk about using Excel or CSV file to go into the Tableau. And then we talk a little bit about the data type. So you can interchange in your data type in the Tableau as well. And then we talk about a little bit about the Tableau UI. And then the difference, we'll explain more actually, the dimension and measure. So this is just a simple simple concept of the dimension of measure. But while in UI, when we are learning other stuff in the analysis in Tableau, we do know more about the difference with the dimension and measures. And then the show me function is showing that the graph of the Tableau. You can easily to do interchange between the graph. So as well as I have create some simple pie chart. And then I also describe what is dashboard and the story mode. That is for you to report to your analysis. So here will be you can check double click that and then change the name of the different mode. So up to here, do you have any questions? So data file maybe we will have thing have maybe share drive to let you to try out. So okay. So in generally we talk about about the data file. So for today's homework is about to install the Tableau, Tableau public. So any question beside that?
One user is asking what is the difference between story and the dashboard.
Story and the dashboard. Okay. So that's so the story mode is the special function of the Tableau. Is that that's all the reporting it is also for reportings. So dashboard is like more in the graph like that. And then story mode is when you explain that in the in your presentation, you can move around the graph. So this is a different type of presentation. Any more questions?
Yes, we can use real-time data. That is the only motive of BIDs. Ultimately, what happens is when we create dashboards and reports on multiple BI tools, including Tableau or Power BI, initially we get started with preparing some dashboard for local system, or local machine, or local database, right? But ultimately, when you deploy that into your company's infrastructure, then you can implement the real-time data as well. So of course, it handles the real-time data as well. Okay, thank you everyone. Thanks all you for the class. I hope people enjoyed it. So we'll be sending you all the details exactly by tomorrow 10 a.m. So in case by 10:30 you don't find the mails in your email box, search in your spam, promotions or inbox. If you don't find anywhere, I have already given our email IDs. Let me just repeat it. So this is where you can send out all your concerns. Danny, your email ID is right. It's correct, right? Danny.e. Yeah. Okay, so both the email IDs are already given to you. So just wait for the class recording and whatever was taught so far, we'll be sending you by tomorrow's, tomorrow 10 o'clock in the morning, and see you in tomorrow's class. See you guys, bye-bye. And in the mail itself, you'll also get a QR code. which you can scan and probably post it on LinkedIn as well, so that you know, you can just inform the outsiders that yeah, you are attending the 7-day challenge, which will be beneficial for you and the company as well. Okay, see you tomorrow.